you can spread it like flu. When someone smiled at me today, I started smiling too. I passed round the corner and someone saw my grin. When he smiled, I realized I passed it on to him. I thought about that smile, then I realized its worth. A single smile, just like mine, could travel round the earth. So if you feel a smile begin, don't leave it undetected. Let's start an epidemic quick and get the world infected. In this poem lies the mission of our 6-day camp here. And the mission is what? To see a smile on each and everyone's face here. And so that we can all walk together to create a smile civilization. So I'll start with a very good morning to each one of you. And again, a nice welcome. Have a nice 6-day action-packed camp here, where I'm sure you all get to learn so much. And that's the mission of this camp. But if we have, got all together here, there must be a reason, a purpose behind all this. You see, we all want to be happy in life. We all want to be very peaceful. We want to see smiles around us. Isn't it so? We want to do that. Whether we are sick, whether we are fine, whether our life is in alignment, or we are sad, or there's a tragedy, we are all looking for goodness around. Ki aas paas humare sab haste rahe, smile karte rahe. And so there we must understand that this is His way, God's way, that we have all collected here today. That He's pushed us into this opportunity and we must make the best of this opportunity and involve ourselves fully and completely, like Justine just mentioned. And God wants us to be happy because we are His children and He knows that we have the power within our body, within ourselves, to cure and heal ourselves. All we need is a guru to show us the path to smile civilization. And who better can be than Mrs. Rupinder Chadha? People who we have all worked together will vouch with me that she is she is an excellent guru. I mean, I have not found a better guru than her, and so but we are learning from you. Yes, he's your guru and our guru all, but directly we have learned from her. She has an amazing, peaceful, smiling aura all around her, and all the while, let me tell you, there's not a minute when you can find some other emotion on her face. She has achieved that level of high level of, smiles, where she can maintain the smile all the while under all situations. She will teach us how we have to, do a reality check of ourselves, understand our negativities, what we have, whether it is anger, whether it is jealousy or non-forgiveness, and how we can transform them into positive ones like love, compassion, peace, and above all, smiles. We should somehow learn to smile. That is what she's going to teach us, that we have to learn to smile from within. We have to create an inner smile and then transform our lives, which will help us heal our body, mind and soul. So that is what we're going to learn. And once you will realize that once we've reached that level of being happy ourselves, there'll be some kind of an instinct which will bond you like to inspire others with happiness. You try to create happiness into others' life. And that is there where you'll achieve this level of high. Your situations will change. Your karmic cycle will be absolutely clear of your previous karmic karmas. And that is all now. And all that will be left is to rely on will be on faith. We should have utmost faith in whatever we are into. And on faith, I remember there's a song where my mother was very fond of, and I am also so fond of it. And in very trying times, this is the best song which helps you to rebuild your faith. And we'll just play that song, and I'll request if you all can join it, and you'll find an instant energy boost in you with this song. And whenever you are under trying times, play this. Thank you.
Amen.